You know what that stands for?
Trans.
Right.
We can fake it, how hard could it be?
I don't even know what telemarketing is, do you?
Sure. You do people's marketing for them. Like when the cook has a day off and you call the market and ask them to deliver. Telemarketing. Tons of jobs in here. Machinist. Lathe milling machine operators for a drill press.
You're gonna operate a drill press, Chuck?
Why not? I'm pretty strong.
You know what they'll do?
They'll go in there and they'll put you in the drill press machine.
They'll drill press you. First, they'll drill you.
No.
Then they'll press you. A bunch of big burly working men wouldn't stand a chance.
No, they wouldn't. They take us under their wing.
Drill press operators don't have wings. They have huge, thick arms with hairy armpits.
I don't think you want to be taken under
there. There's a phone number. Do you have your phone?
Here's one for you, Charlie. Participant needed for medical experiment. $10 an hour.
What did you need?
Subject needed for a variety of medical tests, including submersion in urine and sticking fingers in electrical sockets.
Party bar, bar. Mid-level manager?
Charlie, would you cut that shit out? Deal with reality for a second.
This is reality.
No, reality is that you're 12. You go to school. What kind of job are you gonna get?
Let's see, night watchman?
You're not. No job you have is gonna get us out of debt.
I mean, if we save enough.
We're millions of dollars in debt.
I don't.
Millions?
Well, you know what the Post says? It says that Dad has $18 million hidden in a bank account in the Cayman Islands.
Post says that?
I clipped it.
Too bad the Post is full of shit.
True. Come on, Borden, let's get a job.
I don't want a job. Look at this room. We live here now.
It's not that bad.
Have you tried the sink yet?
No.
The water's brown. I mean, what is that? Did they mix up the sink with someone's toilet?
I have one question for you.
What?
I've heard about communism.
What does that have to do with anything?
I mean, John Lennon would be complaining about this apartment.
John Lennon?
Carl Lennon.
Karl Marx.
Fine. Do you think they just sat around and whined about how shitty their apartments were?
No, well, this apartment sucks.
You still claim to be a communist.
Socialist.
What's the difference?
You take too long to explain.
I've got time.
All right. Communists, they're a bit more hardline.
Hardline?
They won't take no for an answer. They're communist, and they want everybody else in the world to be communist. End of story.
And socialists?
Socialists are a bit more mellow. A little more live and let live, you know? What? What?
No, it's just that this whole time you don't even know what communism means. Do you believe in everyone owning everything and taking from the rich and giving to the poor? Because if you were actually a socialist, you wouldn't be complaining too much about this room.
Fine. I don't believe in socialism. Is that what you want?
I'm just trying to find out what you believe in. What do do you believe in, Porter?
I'm 16. I believe in having a good time. I believe in my friends. Jimi Hendrix, the Dead Kennedys, sports, the Mets, Doc Gooden. I think they're going to go all the way this year. You know, I know what I don't believe in. Sometimes that's just as important as what you do believe in.